The Oscars, or the Academy Awards, are considered one of the most prestigious and recognized awards in the film industry. They are organized by the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences and honor outstanding achievements in various categories related to the production of films. Since 1929, only a small percentage of those in the film industry have either been nominated or received the coveted Golden Statue. Among them have been five people from Puerto Rico. To begin, we will first list those who have had the distinction of only being nominated. The first on the list is Jose Rivera. Born on March 24, 1955 in San Juan, Puerto Rico, Rivera is a talented playwright and screenwriter who has made significant contributions to both theater and film. In 2004, he received an Academy Award nomination for Best Adapted Screenplay for the film The Motorcycle Diaries, which is based on the travel journals of Ernesto Che Guevara. The film explores Guevara's early experiences traveling through South America before he became a revolutionary. Rivera has also gained recognition for his work in the theater, particularly for his play, Marisol, which premiered in 1993 and received critical acclaim. The next one is Jacobo Morales. Born on November 4th, 1934 in Lajas, Puerto Rico, Morales is a highly respected Puerto Rican actor, poet, writer, playwright, and filmmaker known for his significant contributions to the arts and culture. In 1990, he received an Academy Award nomination for Best Foreign Language Film for the critically acclaimed Lo que le pasó a Santiago. The film is a comedy that tells the story of a recently retired widower who meets a mysterious young lady who disrupts his daily routines. Morales has also had a successful acting career, appearing in numerous Puerto Rican and international films, including Dios los Cría in 1955 and La Gran Fiesta in 1986. The next three did not only win the Academy Award, but they were also either nominated more than once or were trailblazers, not only for Puerto Ricans, but for Hispanic people in general. The first was Jose Ferrer. Born on January 8, 1912, in Santurce, San Juan, Puerto Rico, Ferrer was a highly accomplished Puerto Rican actor, director, and producer known for his versatile talents across stage and screen. He made his Broadway debut in 1935 and has appeared in numerous films, including The Caine Mutiny in 1954 and Lawrence of Arabia in 1962. He has received three Academy Award nominations. The first was in 1948 when he was nominated as Best Supporting Actor in the film Joan of Arc, becoming the first Puerto Rican and Hispanic person in general to receive an Academy Award nomination. In the film, he played the role of the heir to the King of France during the time of Joan of Arc. In 1950, Ferrer was nominated and won the Academy Award for Best Actor in the film Cyrano de Bergerac. Ferrer played the role of a poet and supreme swordsman in 17th century Paris, who stops a play from being shown because he can't stand the actor. In 2022, the film was selected for preservation in the United States National Film Registry by the Library of Congress as being culturally and historically significant. As the lead actor in the film, Ferrer became the first Puerto Rican and the first Hispanic to win an Academy Award. In 1952, he was also nominated for an Academy Award for Best Actor in the film Moulin Rouge. He played the role of an artist in 19th century Paris's bohemian subculture in and around the Moulin Rouge, a burlesque palace. And an interesting note, Ferrer was also the uncle of famed actor George Clooney. Jose Ferrer passed away on January 26, 1992 in Coral Gables, Florida, leaving behind a rich legacy in the world of entertainment. Our next Academy Award winner is Benicio del Toro. Born on February 19, 1967 in San Germán, Puerto Rico, del Toro is a Puerto Rican actor and film producer known for his compelling performances and versatility in a wide range of roles. Del Toro has been involved in a variety of films across different genres. Some of his notable works include The Usual Suspects in 1995, Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas in 1998, Che in 2008, and Sicario in 2015. He is considered one of the best actors in the film industry today. He has received two Academy Award nominations. The first was in the year 2000 when he was nominated and won for Best Supporting Actor in the movie Traffic. Del Toro played the role of an honest police officer in the corrupt, infested Mexican police and army during the height of the drug traffic between the U.S. and Mexico. Del Toro has the distinction of being the only actor for winning in this category for a Spanish-speaking role. In 2003, he was again nominated for an Academy Award for Best Supporting Actor in the film 21 Grams. He played the role of a former convict who is using his newfound religious faith to recover from drug addiction and alcoholism. Aside from his Academy Award nominations and win, Del Toro is one of the most award-winning actors in Hollywood. And finally, there is Rita Moreno. Born on December 11, 1931, in Humacao, Puerto Rico, Moreno is a legendary Puerto Rican actress, singer, and dancer who has had a groundbreaking and illustrious career in the entertainment industry. She began her career as a dancer in Spanish Harlem before making her Broadway debut in 1945. In 1961, Rita Moreno was nominated and won the Academy Award for Best Supporting Actress in the highly acclaimed musical West Side Story. Moreno played the role of Anita, the girlfriend of a gang leader and the confidant of his sister Maria in 1950s New York City tale of two rival gangs. The win gave her the distinction of the first Puerto Rican actress to be nominated and the first Latina to win. Another unique distinction for Rita Moreno is that she is one of 19 actors, producers, directors, and composers who is an EGOT. An EGOT is an individual who has won an Emmy Award, a Grammy Award, an Oscar, and a Tony Award. That means that they have to show that they are talented in television, music, movies, and theater. And that is not an easy task. And to top it off, in 2004, Moreno also received the Presidential Medal of Freedom, the highest civilian honor in the United States, for her contributions to the arts and her advocacy work. Let us know what you think in the comment section below. Help us to spread this video by sharing. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell for more videos.